Hello, it's Nancy, and today is day 7 of my 30-day video challenge to get a video up on YouTube every day for 30 days, one that's pertinent to realtors. So I know that's who's watching right now, so thank you for doing that. 5 Ways to Become a Top Listing Agent is the title of this video. It, by special request, someone requested this. We had a conversation, he wants to go in real estate. But he does not want to fail, so he surmised that he wants to become a top listing agent and start that process from day one, which is great. I think that's awesome. So, number one, and I did this early on in my career, you have to prospect for listings every day. And what does that mean? Who do you call? What do you say? Those types of things. So, the people to call are people who you know really need to sell their home. Instead of calling to find out if people need to sell their home, because you have to make a lot of those calls, call the people that you're sure they want to sell their home. And the best two are for sale by owners because they're trying to sell their home, and expired listings because they did try to sell their home and for some reason it did not sell with another realtor, and there's lots of reasons for that. So those are the best two people or groups of people to call when you want to be a listing agent and you're brand new in real estate. And a lot of new agents do call for sale by owners anyway. But here's the thing. They call three or four. They don't follow up later on to see what happened. Sometimes they get hung up on, and that's where they give up because it's hard to call people you don't know. So you have to know what to say when you call so that you don't get hung up on. And once in a while, you're still going to get hung up on. So, where do you find them? You can find them on Zillow. They're all over Zillow. You can find them on different sites on the internet. So, they are out there. They're advertising their home. Some of them may even be in some print media like the newspaper, but they are out there. The expired listings you can find in the expired listing section of your local MLS. So, there are ways to find them. That's not hard. You can also subscribe to a service. There's several services out there that will send for sale by owners to you every morning and send expired listings to you, you know, every day. So you can also have that. But those two groups of people would be the best people to find and call when you want to become a top listing agent. And you will list them if you do it right and if you do enough of it. So doing it right means don't just pick three or four that you're going to call and that's it. Find all of them. Find all of them in your market area and call all of them. You'll get better at it. You'll excel at it. You'll find out by asking them certain questions which ones are motivated and which ones aren't. And here's the thing, over 90% of all for sale by owners eventually list with a realtor. So you want to be that realtor. And you just have to follow up, follow up, follow up, follow up until they either list with you or list with somebody else or take their house off the market, change their mind, or whatever. It's a process, and you can become very, very good at this process. After calling, you can send them notes, you can send follow-up mail. If you get their email address, you can follow up email, but I wouldn't recommend follow-up email because not many people open their email. But follow-up letters, follow-up notes, every time you talk to them, send them another note with your card in it. And don't give up because that's what happens. People say, I tried that and it didn't work. Well, they didn't try it hard enough. They didn't learn enough to do it well. They didn't do enough to do it well. So I would say, follow, if you're going to do that, 20 to 30 for sale by owners at a time and check every single day and call the new ones as soon as they pop up. That will make you better. Now, what do you say to them? And that's the next thing is you got to learn your scripts and dialogues. But that's number two. Other people, and number one, people calling people that you don't know. Let me go back to that for just a minute. Owners with high scores in an algorithm program, which we didn't used to have, but I will tell you, I've done this. I used to have an algorithm program before Remind was out. There was one that I purchased, and it was called Offers, OFFRS. They don't have the E in it. And I did that to test the market to see if it would work. And I called sporadically and I got four listings out of it that I gave to other agents. And I was just testing the market because we also gave other agents these leads and they didn't seem to get much off of it. But if you sit one morning and you call people with a high score, you're going to get prospects. You're going to get a prospect who wants to list. I got people who wanted to list for all kinds of different reasons. So offers did work. Now we have Remind. Those algorithms who give people a high score are 70% accurate. It's going to cut your calling time down instead of circle prospecting. You call people that are more likely to sell. So for sale by owners, expired listings, and then people out of an algorithm program like Remind or Offers are going to be your next best thing. And by calling those people, the next best thing after that is absentee owners and owners of residential income property like duplexes and triplexes and things like that. Those would be the next best two. You can follow up with probate. You can try to work with divorce attorneys. But I gave you the best ones first, trust me. That's the best ones first. Now, number two, become extremely proficient with your scripts for when you call. And that is very, very important to become proficient. You've got to find the scripts, and they're on websites of the two best coaches in real estate, Mike Ferry and Tom Ferry. Okay, so they're there. You can use them. They work. They worked for me. I know they'll work for you. So you practice. You role play with someone. You internalize, memorize, and internalize the scripts. I covered some of this in another video. Learn your scripts, because if you know your scripts well, when you call, you'll get better results. You'll get better results. Okay. Everybody for sale by owner is going to say, yeah, I'll pay you 2.5% or 3% if you sell it. So they're going to tell you that there's something that you say in reply to that that's going to get you an appointment. So get the scripts and dialogues, learn them, read them back to yourself, practice with someone that you know, and get those scripts down. That's number two. Number three, have a top-notch coach that will hold you highly accountable to making your calls every day. We're told that you've got to talk to somewhere between 50 and 150 people in order to get a transaction, a listing, or a buyer. However, if you narrow it down to the people that you know need to sell, like the people that I talked to about number one, it's going to lower the number of people you have to talk to before you get a deal, before you get a listing. So you definitely want to focus on what I told you at number one, for sure. And getting a coach, a top-notch coach, the Mike Ferry Organization, the Tom Ferry Organization are the two best. I've coached with both of them. Mike Ferry early on, because Tom used to work for Mike. I called for sale by owners. I did what they told me to do. And when I did what they told me to do, I got a lot of listings. So if you want to become a top listing agent, I would get a coach as soon as possible. Now, if you can't afford that in the beginning, there's a lot of YouTube videos that show people, agents, calling for sale by owners. They're using some of those scripts. You can watch them before you do it. If you would like, I will send you the YouTube videos that are the videoers that are doing that. And they do a pretty good job. And it's real life. They're doing live for sale by owner calls and expired calls right in front of your eyes to show you how to do it. So if you can't afford a coach, go watch them. But you can copy those scripts right off those two websites. So I would definitely do that. That's going to narrow it's going to reduce your learning time. And that's what you want to do. You want to become proficient faster, and you want to get listings faster. That's going to lead you to that. Now, when you go on those listing appointments, don't tell people you're new. Use your company stats. If you want to, if you felt comfortable, you could take a more experienced realtor with you. That's okay. And share the listing with them, because you've got the appointment. They've got the expertise to get it signed. Okay. So you could do that. But number three is a top-notch coach, for sure, as soon as you can afford it. If not, the internet will help you, and I'll help you find them in the internet. I'll even shorten your time on that. Number four, we talked about this in another video, a strict schedule. We have no idea how much time we waste every day with things that are not going to pay us in our business. So if you have a strict schedule, what are you going to do? And the first thing in the morning when you get up, you're going to do your affirmations, you're going to do a meditation, or you're going to exercise, or whatever your ritual is. But have a ritual that starts early and that gets you off on the right foot in the morning. So that is number four. Hal Elrod's Miracle Mornings is a great book to read to help you get your morning started right, because I'm going to tell you what, you've got to have a strong mindset if you're going to do this from day one. A strong mindset will take you far. You're going to know what you want, you're going to go after it, and you're not going to let anything stand in your way, including other people who want to call you on the phone and chat, or other realtors in the hallway, or whatever it is that gets in your way. You can't let anything get in your way. So by 8 o'clock in the morning, or even earlier, you've got to be looking at who you're going to call that day. That's a schedule. So you're going to be looking at it. You may have to do some research to look some things up. But by 8:30, you should be on that phone making those calls for at least 2 hours a day. And then follow-up calls. So you make your first call, you make your first calls first. In other words, if you've never talked to those people before, that's the people you call first. And you want to get them when they first come on the market, those for sale by owners. Same thing with expireds. You want to get them when they first come on the market. So that's what you spend your time doing, or invest your time doing. Now, the second part of your schedule that day is to follow up with the people that you've already talked to once or twice or three or four times. Call those people back, right? See how they're doing. Check up on them, because that's your next listing. One of those people is your next listing. That is awesome to know. So strict with your time. Make your appointments in the afternoon. If you want to go preview homes, if you want to go visit for sale by owners, do that in the afternoon. Do your calls in the morning. That's the way to be successful and be a top listing agent. Make those appointments in the afternoon. And if you get an appointment, don't stop during that 2 hour time period. Keep calling the rest of them. Don't give up. If you run out of people to call, then call old expireds. Okay? Call old expireds. So, but call somebody and use that few hours a day. That is your power hours. That's the time that you want to make the most money you can in real estate. And those people need you. They already held their hand up. I need help. I'm a for sale by owner. I need help. My listing expired with another realtor. I need a better realtor. I need somebody to tell me why my house didn't sell and get it sold for me. I still want to go. So number four, strict schedule. Stick to it. Your time is your most precious thing you have. Use it wisely. Control your time. Don't let anybody else control your time. Okay? Number five, set a goal with a plan and review it every day. Every day, review your goal. Keep it in front of you. Keep your business plan in front of you. Do the same thing every day, 5 days a week. 5 days a week. Keep your mindset. If your mindset starts getting doubtful, work on that mindset. Keep it strong. Read good books. Listen to really good people talk to you on the internet. Don't let that mindset down. Don't let it drop. Keep it strong. You will get through this. Do not be emotionally attached when somebody hangs up on you. Do not be emotionally attached if they don't list with you. There's my favorite four-letter word that I was taught in real estate is next. If they don't want to do business with you, next. Go to the next one. You're never going to run out of for sale by owners. The market is going to continue to supply you with them. You're never going to run out of expired listings. The market is continue to slow. You're never going to run out of people who want to sell their home. There is no shortage. There's not going to be one for you, because you're going to call them every single day. It's a wonderful way to make money in real estate really fast, and to teach you a strength that you will never lose. It's a skill that you won't lose. It's like riding a bicycle. Once you get it, you got it, and nobody can stop you. You can go as high as you want in real estate. After that, you start leveraging, but that's how you become a top listing agent. There's a part two to this. There's a part two to everything I have, which is, what do you do when you start to leverage and you don't have time to make those calls 2 hours a day anymore, or you just don't want to because you're so successful, you want people to call you? That's part two. Don't worry about part two right now. Let's do part one. And I wish you the very best. And if you need any help, you let me know. Take care.